Just 50 years ago, we finally ventured to the moon. For the very first time, we looked back at our own planet. This series will celebrate the natural wonders that remain and reveal what we must preserve to ensure people thrive.
Ladies and gentlemen, what we have here in the deep reaches of the New South Wales western borders, we have something quite rare and unusual. They're called Dungarians. We're going to find out just what Dungarians are all about.
Your fundraising tally for this year is an incredible $302,513.
Be prepared. Dungarians are a strange breed. They come in different shapes and sizes. Come and have a look what we've got in here.
Dungarians, the Roadhog is moving out. We're moving out.
And the Rotary Club of Boona have come to the party to spread these girls have put on, the girls and guys have put on. Unbelievable, check this out. Oh, this is insane. Beautiful.
Everything's looking pretty good, the track's pretty interesting. It's got some big climbs and some big ascents and descents. Some sections where we've got multiple recovery set up, so if that gives you some idea of what we're doing. There's going to be some people that don't believe they could put their car where we're going to put it over the next few days, so should be all pretty good. In saying that, none of it should cause any damage, it's all been planned. Paul's done a great job with the route, checking all that out, so yeah, it should be awesome.
Over here we have the Dungarian newbie. This is their first Dunga Derby, and they're not quite in with the crowd yet because they haven't quite figured out just what's going on. But they're happy, they're silly, not really sure what's going on, but they're having a good time, and they're in the spirit of raising money to help out those in need. That's the Dungarian newbie. Come this way. Then we have some whose partners might be in one car and their wives are in another car.
Absolutely.
And they dress looking like a Teletubby. But you know what? Their meaning and their desire to do something for people in need is amazing, and they never stop trying. These are the Top Gun crew. They're legends, and they will stay with the Dunga Derby for a long, long time. Keep coming.
day one of the Dunga Derby around a little place called Tabulan in northern New South Wales on a steep dirt road, and we met Ron. Tell us about how we met you today, Ron.
Well, I was on a motorcycle trip down to Yarralla, and we came down this Paddy's Flat Road. And at some point or other, I managed to lose control of the front end of the bike and ran off the road.
And it wasn't just a road, it was a road sort of on a cliff, wasn't it?
It definitely was. It was quite a drop off to the side.
Yes.
And my friends who were actually travelling behind me, I was so far down they couldn't actually see me.
That's amazing. So we've come across Ron, actually, luckily the bike wasn't on you and crawling up this gully from about 8 metres down. So we've got there and we've, lucky you're in reasonable shape, but a little bit sore.
A bit sore, but otherwise I'm not seriously injured. But I considered myself pretty lucky considering what has happened. I'm very grateful that you just came along at the right time. You don't anticipate these sort of things happening, but when they do, and the care that I've been shown today has been wonderful.
When we rocked up there, it was pretty scary, actually, to think that this guy's come off and he was about 8 metres down that cliff. So pretty glad to be on the scene.
Yeah, it's good to be there and good to provide the assistance. And I'm actually glad that he's come out of it quite well. The bike looks a little bit worse for wear, but he landed on top of the bike down the cliff, which we still can't figure out how we did that with the direction he was travelling, but he was very fortunate.
Dunga's line up to the very left, please. Keep the right-hand side lane open.
This is the king of the Dunga at the moment. His name is Half Metre Peter. And Half Metre Peter, he's the one that has to organise everyone around to make sure that the Dunga Derby is a success. What he does in his spare time, no one really knows, but he's here and he's trying to keep everything going. Sometimes it stresses him out. As you can see, not a lot of hair left there and reasonably grey. We would be lost without the Dungarian king, Half Metre Peter.
I don't know,
I wasn't doubting your...
The flags are there, we're in the right spot.
Yeah, I know, I wasn't doubting the navigation.
Even though I'm a kilometre out.
The plane, now we say the flag.
Let's play What Did She Say?
Do you want to stop there for a sec? Just give us a moment.
For what?
Stop there for a sec and give us a moment.
Oh.
Then we step up a level to the Dungarian. I've been here a few times. And this is what you get.
And this is number one.
As you can see, there's a step up. He obviously is in the green little group. And he's ready for business. Tonight is a talent night. They're raising money and they're trying to show everyone just how talented they are. Or really how talented they are. Like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out.
bothered me anyway.
The red team. Here's the red wiggle. Watch him later on this evening because he's bound to be involved in something a little bit lurid, something a little bit crude, but he will be doing it in the name of raising money for the Dunga Derby. This is Tony, leader of the red wiggles. Give us a little wave, Tony.
Sexy thing, you. I believe in miracles. Since you came along, you sexy thing. We really regret that there is only one winner, and the winner is.
I'm sexy and I know it. Sexy and I know it.
Oh, mate.
That ain't gone.
I'm gonna stop there for a sec. Just give us a moment.
For what? Well, it's a great song.
Must be all Child, the way.
Machine gun's ready to go. Are you ready? You ready for this?
Our brand new ones, but our participants this year that have returned have got such passion and love for the charity, and they are really welcoming all of our brand new teams in and sharing the love with them of what the charity is all about.
But what we have here are known as the Dungarian Mini Mix. You see, Michael Irwin is really the head of the Dungarian family, one of the creators, one of the inventors of it. But then he has this raft of people who are belonging to the actual Grease Monkey crew, but they want to be Michael. So here they are performing, dressed up as Mini Mick. If that isn't a show of devotion and support for the Dunga Derby, then I don't know what is. And they're even wearing butterfly wings, just to show you their feminine side, because while they might be grease monkeys, they also have a very feminine, happy side. We love the Dunga Derby.
I would just like to add that Mick told us we had to dress up like this, or we weren't allowed to come again.
Come to those people that are more likely to get their hands dirty. This is Trevor, head of the Grease Monkeys. If he's not fixing your car, he's doing something to annoy the hell out of someone that's on the Dunga Derby. He's very good at it, and he never stops doing it.
Sunshine Coast Dunga for 2023. All of the cars have officially made it back, except for those that didn't.
We've got all of the cars home, except for a 45 series, a little short wheelbase that busted on day one. But they came home with us as well because they were in the Burson's recovery car, the little Ferozza.
It's important for us to stop and think about our impact over the past 12 months. When we talk about our growth across the community and the growth of the Dunga family, we've seen significant increase across our fundraising, across our team registration, across our sponsorship, and also across our recipient impact.
And we're going to help $300,000 worth of recipients in this next year on the Sunshine Coast. It's just going to be awesome.
What that means is, because our fundraising has been so extraordinary, we're going to be able to support these Sunshine Coast local families well into the future.
So there we are, people. If you've ever wondered what the Dungarian and the Dunga family is all about, that is a very broad cross-section of a wonderful, marvellous group of people doing their best to raise money for those that need it. God bless the Dungarian family.
No animals were hurt in the making of this documentary, except this one. This one was really, really hurt. Thanks, Jess.
Because this morning when they're talking about a deer getting hit, I yelled out, "Yeah, Leo!" And then not 17 minutes later, I hit a deer wallaby. So yeah. Guess what? Yeah, Jess!
And unfortunately, the little Joey died as well.
Stop it! No.